Rikki Mishra, Director of Asiatic International Business Academy, welcome you all on this great and amazing platform of learning. It is well said that there is no end to education. It is not that you read a book and passed the exam and finished the education. The whole of life, from the moment you are born to the moment you die, is a process of learning. So, with special excitement and eagerness to learn new things, I am pleased to welcome Ms. Shelly Sharma on behalf of the entire team of Aircrew Aviation Private Limited and Asiatic International Business Academy. It is an honor for me to introduce our special guest of the day in the International Webinar 2020. Ms. Shelly Sharma is an experienced quality manager with a demonstrated history of working in the airline or aviation industry. She is skilled in quality control, internal audit, quality audit, aircraft maintenance, etc. At present, she is working as freelance with Reliance Aviation Academy. So here we have gigantic opportunity to learn from Ms. Shelly. Thank you so much for being here. Now it's all up to you. Thank you once again.
Thank you, Rekhi, for introducing me so well. And hello, everyone. Hope you are having a good day till today. And now, let me share my screen with you. Hope it is visible to you all.
Video is off.
Okay. What about my screen? Is it shared?
Yeah. Yes, it's visible.
Yeah. Okay, fine. Should I start video or without video is okay?
Your video, that would look.
Okay, wait. Hello, everyone. Hope you can hear me.
Yes, we all can hear you.
Okay. Now, let me start with this introduction of mine. I am Shelly Sharma. Already, Rekhi has invited me well. So, I have total 11 years experience in aviation. And today, I am giving webinar on human factor. So let me start with my slide without wasting your much of your time. So this is the one. So basically, human factor is the capability and limitations, understanding of capabilities and limitations of human and their performances in their working area and environment. Okay. So the origin of human factor is basically from, it has come because many accidents has happened in past few years. So FAA has initiated this human factor as a study in aviation and also in other fields also. So it is a program initially designed by FAA, Federal Aviation Administration. The focus is on the employees who built and maintain all aircraft engines and aircrafts. The tool and techniques have been modified for the need of all business. Then to characterize the impact of environmental, external, internal, and individual factor on human performances. To understand the chain of events that can cause accident or incident, like defect or errors. These events can lead to the endangerment of the employee and the product and also our customers. To create awareness and to examine the human role in the workplace. Basically, what is human factor? The screen is visible fully to everyone. Hello?
Yes, it is.
And you can interrupt me in between for questions and all, no problem. So this human factor is also known as ergonomics of science. This is a study of mental and physical capabilities of human and their limitations. Now, this is the analysis tool. First is shell model. So here in this model, S is stand for software, H stands for hardware, E stands for environment, and L stands for liveware. So basically, this software you can consider as our manuals and all our tools, other which with the help of which we are performing in our aviation industry. Then hardware are for hardware, you can say all our manuals and other books which should be updated. And if it is not updated or something, if we are reading those books which are unupdated, then there are more chances we will do some mistake or error in our field, which is called human error. Which is like human error is basically a failure of planned result, which you are have planned, you are doing something, you are working onto something, and you are not able to achieve the performance or outcome. So that is called human error. And to reduce this human error, we are basically reading all this human factor. So this is the study of science of a human, basically. So here, the environment also play a very main role, because if environmental conditions are not good, then also your performance will affect. You will not be able to perform as good as you wanted to perform in proper weather or environmental condition. Like if lights are not proper, you cannot able to see the manual, software, hardware properly, and you are making mistakes because of these conditions. So these conditions should be taken care of. So this is basically interrelationship between human factors and aviation environment or any other environment, because nowadays it is not only in aviation, it has started this study of human factor in also medical science and other big business and other sectors also. But in case of aviation, it is very much important, because this affect the effectiveness of employee. How? We'll see now. Like human factor attributes, which is dependable, willing to put in effort and hours, high integrity, modesty, distrust, prefer to allow to make his or her decision, does not like to ask for help, tend to be self-sufficient, like to think out on his or her own. Then this is again one analysis tool which has given named as Dirty Dozen, which is basically given us 12 clues with the help of which we can analyze the study of human performance in their public area or public sector, like in aviation. It has been determined by researching mistakes caused by people. So these are the 12 clues which are known as Dirty Dozen. This is first, lack of communication, complacency, lack of knowledge, distractions, lack of teamwork, fatigue, lack of resources, pressure, lack of assertiveness, stress, lack of awareness, and norms. So these are the 12 clues given by Dirty Dozen to study this human factor more nicely. So now we'll see in detail what these factors and how they can affect our human factor and science of study of human. This is not only physical science, this is also mental and physical activities of human. So this is communication first. So lack of communication means written, verbal, tone of voice, body language. So communication is very important. As if in case of aviation, if shift in charge has found out something in first shift, and if he is not able to communicate well to the other shift in charge, then there are chances that can create some kind of error, human error. Does this sound familiar? What you heard and what I said are two different things, and what you think I said is definitely not what I meant. It means jo bhi aap convey kar rahe hain, whatever you want to convey to your colleague, that should be conveyed well, clear voice, or else written or in writing, so that he or she should understand the exact meaning what you wanted to convey to him or her. Then to improve communication, what should you do, what you can do to improve your communication? Learn to listen first. Ask questions. If you do not understand anything, you can ask questions. Make eye contact. Paraphrase. Use positive body language, approved process and worksheet. Use already approved and authentic worksheets. Discuss open item on paper. Never assume anything. Don't assume anything. Whenever somebody is saying you anything, or if it is given in return, you should go by the books. You should not assume anything. So this is all about communication. Now, complacency. So this is basically a conscious or unconscious relaxation of one's usual standard in making decisions and taking actions. Improving complacency means train yourself to expect to find a problem. Tasks are more likely included in the work instructions because of potential critical failure or past historical failure. Never pass along work without ensuring its correctness. If you are not insured about the correctness of work, don't pass it to the next person. If you are sure that it is correct, then only you pass. Otherwise, if you are passing also, you should tell them personally or in return that this is not 100% correct. So they can also check it on second time on you. Second, human factor, lack of knowledge. Next point. Failure to provide adequate training. Lack of confidence to ask questions. Understand each step of what you are doing, or if you don't have knowledge, talk to someone who does. अगर आपको knowledge नहीं है, आप किसी से बात कर सकते हैं किस बारे में कि ये क्या बात हो रही है, उसका knowledge ले सकते हैं, then you can start your work on. Seek training on the type of work to be performed. Whatever work you are going to perform, prepare yourself for performing it well. You can go on training for those particular tasks. Always use current procedure and work instructions. Always use current and updated procedures. You cannot use old procedures or old versions of that particular work. If it's new, don't be afraid to ask. If you are new, then you can ask what is the correct procedure to do the work, to perform the work. What are the current status of this particular manual or something, so that you can perform it well. Then lack of teamwork. Lack of teamwork can lead to failure to understand your role. No team training is given, then also you will not perform as per the mark. Then not understanding the benefit of working in teams. So these are all reasons why your teamwork is not up to the mark. Distraction. To draw one's attention away. To confuse by unclear instructions. If you get confused by unclear instructions, you have to read it again and again. If it is not clear to you, you can ask your senior or your management, what is the exact instruction? Then only you perform on that instruction. You should not do like that. You have got any information and blindly doing work on that. If it is unclear, you go ask again and again, no problem. But if you are creating any error, especially in aviation, we don't have any scope to take this kind of errors. So this is very important in aviation sector. Then excessive non-work related activities. How to improve your distraction? Know where you left off the uncompleted work. You should know where you have left your uncompleted work. Then you can start from that particular point. Second, when you return to the job, go back and review the few steps in the process. Okay, use check sheets to avoid errors. You can use your check sheets to avoid errors. You can make a checklist what you should go through and what you can do. And then only you can perform your work. Then it will be go up to the mark. If in doubt, make a write-up of the uncompleted task. If you are not sure you will remember it in the next day, you can make a write-up and then you can come up in the next shift and you can read and then you can perform your work. Improve teamwork, provide instructions for working in teams, discuss what, who, and how a job is to be done. Be sure that everyone understands and agrees. If everyone is not agree, then you can discuss among yourself and your team how and who is performing this job and how you can perform this job and what has to be performed as per the instructions given by the team, and you can discuss among your team. This is the way you can improve your teamwork also, teamwork quality. Now, fatigue. What is fatigue? The result of intense physical or mental activity at a single task can create fatigue. What are the causes? Like already I said about the temperature and lighting. This is temperature variations, excessive noise, strong lighting, long work hours. Like if you have very excessive noise, we are talking now, we are in a meeting, and if a very excessive noise is coming in from behind or something, then also your work will hamper. So temperature also, if there is very hot temperature or very cold temperature, then also it will affect to your work performance. So this basically, these factors affect your efficiency and your capabilities. So these are your limitations. You can perform well in this temperature or what light is proper to your performance, that you have to judge. That particular area, normally we have any general temperature, general noise, that is to be maintained. Strong lighting should not be there, otherwise also it will cause effect. Working hours should be minimum or given by the guidelines. It should not be like you can continuously working in two shift or three shift, then obviously your performance will hamper. So this is the things, these are the causes which can create fatigue. Then fatigue denotes a state represented by a loss in efficiency and a general disinclination to the work. Improving fatigue. How you can improve fatigue? Be aware of the symptoms of fatigue and look for them in yourself and others. You should be aware of what is exactly the fatigue is and how it is affecting you. Sleep and exercise regularly. Ask others to check your work. Avoid excessive overtime. Already I told you, if you are working in 2-3 shifts continuously, then obviously your performance will affect. So you should avoid excessive work time, excessive overtime. Ask others to check your work. If you are not sure of your work, what you have done, you can ask anyone to check you on your work so that you will be double sure that your work is proper and completed. Sleep and exercise regularly. Human factors. Next point, resource pressure. Making do with less. Example, inexpensive and inadequate tools or equipments. Outdated computer or software, unreliable copiers, inadequate lighting, outdated manuals or procedures documentation. Like if you are working with outdated manuals and procedures, obviously there are chances that you will do it wrong because procedures has updated now and you are not using the updated one. So obviously you will do your job wrong. That way you have to be proper that your manuals and all documents should be current and updated. All manuals should be of current revision number and all your computer and softwares all should be updated and current. If you are using any copy of any manual or something, it should be reliable copy. It should not be unreliable copy so that you will make mistake. Improving resource pressure. Make a list of required resource that will reduce your work pressure. Track the progress. If you want to improve your resource pressure, then you can do one thing. You can make a list which can reduce your work pressure and you can ask your management to bring those resources for you. Pressure to complete the work on time when expected. Most often the pressure comes from within ourselves. Reducing work pressure. Ensure the pressure isn't self-induced. Communicate your concern upward and ask for question. So pressure is normally when you think that this work, how it is going to happen, how and when I have to do it, how there is some deadline is given, then you take pressure of that particular work. So how you can reduce that? You can communicate your concerns with your management and your team, your bosses, all your colleagues, and you can ask for help also. If you are thinking that your workload is too much, you can divide it with your team. You can discuss with your management. This is the way you can reduce your work pressure also. Then lack of assertiveness, improving assertiveness. Record the incident in a personal log. Refuse to compromise your standard. How you can improve your assertiveness? You can record the incident in personal log, which will refuse to compromise your standards. Clearly communicate the consequences. If you are not sure of anything, you communicate it verbally or in written, which will reduce your consequences. Stress, the non-specific response of the body to any demand made upon it. Managing stress, don't make mountains out of molehills. Look rationally at the problem. Break plans down into small steps. If you have to do so much of work, you can break it in small steps, like 1-2. You can make a deadline like 3 days, 5 days, you can do it. It's not necessary to do it in a day only. You can break it properly. Look rationally at the problem. Always be aware how stress personally affect your work. Take a break to clear your mind. Ask for advice or help from someone you can trust. You can ask for advice also to your senior management level person, your colleagues whom you can trust. Then human factor, lack of awareness, failure to realize consequences of actions, improving awareness, think about all the functions required to complete the total task. Will you work conflict with some other person or process? This all go interchange. This all are interconnected. Then human factor, norms. Last point, which is the 12th point, is norms. Never mind the right way. It's quicker the way, do it. How you can improve norms? Always follow the approved procedure. If you are following unapproved procedure, it is illegal. Now, normally, if you are following the approved procedure, there are no chances it will go wrong. If the process is not documented, then document it. Be aware that norms do not make it right. We have choose it. Attitude matters. Attitude is everything. Use knowledge, awareness, break the chain of event, be aware of poor work habits, stay aware, our future business is on it. So basically human factor is social and personal skills. This is basically the issue affecting how people do their jobs. So here I am, this is the last slide of mine. Now, any questions?
May I ask one question?
Yeah, sure.
I have just read one research that a research came out with the fact that employees of the organization, they love to do scuttlebutt. They are very much interested in the gossip. And it is scientifically proved that if employees do gossip, then it will give good mental health.
Gossip doesn't mean, this is again, it comes in communication. So yeah. If you are communicating well, if you are doing gossip, means your interrelationship between the all your employees are very good.
Yeah,
you can take it that way also. If your communication is well, if you are communicating with each other well, then obviously you can communicate with all your positive and negatives. So obviously, yeah. If you are able to tell your boss that you are wrong, that is where your capability and your efficiency of work is suddenly increases. So that is again comes into your communication and teamwork. So obviously if you are communicating well with your team, it will improve your work performance.
Okay.
So you can take it in this way, positive way, but then you can gossip positive in positive sense also.
Yeah, definitely. Otherwise it will increase.
Yeah, it doesn't mean you are gossiping about your family issues, but better to gossip and communicate well among yourself and your about your organization, or about like in aviation, if you are in aviation, you can communicate and discuss about aircrafts and all. So obviously it will reduce your work pressure also.
Yeah.
So that way gossip is also good.
That article mentioned this fact that this will reduce the work pressure and they will give you relief from the mental stress.
Obviously this comes into communication. So yes, one way. Because everything has plus and minus, everything has positive and negative sides. So if you are doing it positively, it will give you good result. And if you are doing it negatively, like if you are gossiping about someone's mother-in-law or someone, then obviously then it will affect your work negatively. So better to gossip about your work and discuss about your company, then obviously okay. It will give positive result.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Ma'am, we all are from the aviation industry. So we just want to know about your experience because you have a gigantic experience in this sector. So kindly summed up your journey of aviation industry.
See, aviation is a very beautiful field. I love it. So I entered into it. But there are very much struggle in it. If you are not ready to do struggle, then obviously it is problematic nowadays because of this pandemic. Already aviation is it is not in good shape. Actually, it is not good time to discuss about employment in aviation. But if you love aviation, if you love this field, if you love aircrafts, I personally love aircrafts a lot. So if you love the field, if you have some courage to sustain the downs also, then surely you will get the positive things also, because this is very good field. You have okay. many opportunities. You can also, if like, may I ask you in which field you are basically?
I'm from HR.
Okay. So HR in aviation is very different. It's not like my profile. But if you are like in proper core aviation, like in maintenance or in crew level, then obviously you can sustain well.
Mm-hmm.